For our third and final dish for our kitchen extravaganza, we've assembled one of my favorite dishes of the year, the grain bowl. And this is something that I love because it's versatile, it's a great way to use leftovers, and you can literally make it whatever you want it to be. In our grain bowl today, we've got a lot going on. But again, you can add as many or as little ingredients as you'd like based on your own preferences. So, the base of our grain bowl is some loose leaf spinach. You can use whatever kind of green that you like and that you have in your refrigerator, or you can omit it altogether. On top of that, I added plenty of one of my favorite grains, which is barley. So it's really cheap, a little bit cooked goes a long way, it's a great source of plant protein and a great source of fiber, which means it's really, really good for our immune health. You can add any kind of grain that you'd like. Think wild rice, think quinoa, think whatever you want to throw together on your stovetop. On top of it, we've added so many different flavors of different veggies and even a little bit of dried fruit because I love sweetness in my grain bowl. So what you'll see here, we've got some sliced grape tomatoes, we've got a red pepper, some thinly sliced orange carrots, a little bit of edamame and chickpeas, again for great protein and fiber. I had leftover roasted vegetables from the other night's dinner, so I threw those on top as well. We love healthy fats, so I've got some chopped walnuts and some avocado. And as I mentioned, I like a little bit of sweetness, so I add some thinly sliced dried apricot. You can add some fresh fruit as well, whatever you prefer. To finish our grain bowl, I added a really simple dressing. So it is a mixture of some tahini, which is ground up sesame seeds. I added some fresh squeezed lemon juice. You could add any sort of acid or vinegar that you'd like. For a touch of sweetness, I used some good quality maple syrup, a little bit of salt and pepper, and to thin it out just a bit, a few teaspoons of water. I gave it a good shake and we'll dress our grain bowl. A little goes a long way. So if you read my blog that I posted not too long ago, you know the grain bowl is my dish for 2020. It's super versatile, it's easy to throw together, it travels well, which means when I'm on the road, it's the perfect lunchtime, it's super filling and really, really nourishing. So for more ideas, check out our blog and our website at uniteforher.org.